how to use the Plan Validation Workspace. Issuers seeking to offer qualified health plans, or QHPs, including standalone dental plans, or SADPs, on the federally facilitated exchange must submit a completed QHP application per CMS guidelines. As part of the QHP certification process, issuers are asked to fill out several templates with issuer and plan level data. These templates, along with any supporting documentation submitted, comprise an issuer's QHP application. Issuers offering QHPs or SADPs in federally facilitated exchange, or FFE states, submit the majority of their QHP application materials in the Marketplace Plan Management System, or MPMS, module within the Health Insurance Oversight System, or HIOS. The MPMS module is a web application that allows issuers to submit QHPs and SADPs to CMS for review and certification, as well as validate plan data prior to submission. All issuers seeking certification, regardless of state exchange model, require access to the MPMS module. Although issuers in states performing plan management functions and state-based exchanges on the federal platform, or SBEFPs, will continue to submit the majority of their QHP application data to their states through the System for Electronic Rates and Forms Filing, or SERF, before that data is transferred by their state to the MPMS module. Issuers in states without an effective rate review program and issuers that do not have access to SERF use the Unified Rate Review, or URR, module in HIOS as well. For more information on submission systems issuers use to submit QHP application materials, including guidance on how to access those systems, visit the Submission Systems webpage of the QHP Certification website. For more information on which submission systems issuers in different state exchange models use to submit each QHP application material, reference the QHP Certification Issuer Toolkit posted on the Application Submission webpage of the QHP Certification website. The MPMS module is divided into four primary sections. Home, where issuers access announcements pertaining to their applications, metrics about any applications they may have started for the current plan year, and easy navigation to other areas of the system. Plan Validation Workspace, where issuers upload QHP application templates for validation and receive validation results prior to submitting their applications. QHP applications, where issuers create or edit applications, link valid templates uploaded in the Plan Validation Workspace to their applications, complete attestations, provide supplemental application documentation, and access review results provided by CMS, and application tools, which includes the application materials page, where issuers download certain materials, issuer details, where issuers update their machine-readable index URLs, and plan preview, where issuers preview and validate the accuracy of their plan benefit displays for healthcare.gov. Issuers in all states are required to validate their QHP application data for compliance with a number of federal standards prior to submitting these data to CMS or their state. Issuers in FFE states are required to use the Plan Validation Workspace and remediate all identified validation errors prior to submitting their application to CMS. Issuers in states performing plan management functions and in SBEFP states are required to use the Plan Validation Workspace to validate their data prior to submitting their application data to their state in SERF, although these validations are also present in SERF, Validate, and Transform. Validating application data within the Plan Validation Workspace allows issuers to access their pre-submission review results. Pre-submission review results, also called validation results, display as validation errors, which issuers are required to correct prior to submitting an application, and validation warnings, which issuers should review to determine whether a correction needs to be made prior to submitting an application. Issuers will not be able to submit their applications to CMS via the MPMS module or to their state via SERF until all validation errors are resolved. CMS will continue to release post-submission review results, also called required corrections, based on data submitted for CMS review and feedback. While SERF submitting issuers will receive and correct validation errors within SERF Validate and Transform, validation warnings can only be accessed through the Plan Validation Workspace. CMS strongly encourages all issuers take advantage of the Plan Validation Workspace as early as possible to proactively identify both validation errors and warnings, which might otherwise prevent them from submitting their application in a timely manner. Additionally, some states performing plan management functions and SBEFPs may require issuers in their state use the Plan Validation Workspace prior to submitting their application data in SERF. For additional information on both pre- and post-submission review results, please access the QHP Application Review Results webpage of the QHP Certification website. Now let's walk through how to upload and validate QHP application templates within the Plan Validation Workspace. After finalizing your application templates to create an XML extract, navigate to the HIOS MPMS module and select the Plan Validation Workspace tab. Then select the plan year and issuer combination that you need to upload and validate templates for, and click Show Workspace to begin uploading files for validation. The Upload Files section will appear, where you can upload files for validation. Either select Choose from Folder or drag and drop files into the Upload Files section for validation. Successfully uploaded files will display within the Upload Files section, and the system will automatically identify and note the type of template uploaded. You may choose to either remove the file by selecting the trash can icon or selecting the Validate button to proceed with validation. After validating, all validation results will display in the Validation Results section. Issuers have the option to sort this section by product type and market coverage type. The first two columns of the Validation Results section display the template type and file name. You can also view the timestamp for when the file was uploaded and which user uploaded the file. The final two columns display the template validation results and whether or not the template has been linked to a QHP application. In the Validation Results column, one of the following results will display: No errors found, meaning the template passed all validations. Warnings found, meaning the template is acceptable, but you may need to provide a justification if the template is linked to a QHP application, or there is an unexpected data condition being flagged. Errors found, meaning errors are present within the template that require correction before the template can be linked to a QHP application. This status will also display if there are both errors and warnings present in the template. Processing error, meaning a processing error was encountered with the file. This status indicates you should try generating a new XML file using the Finalize button in the applicable template and re-uploading. If warnings or errors are identified, click View Results to review a list of the identified validation errors and warnings. The list of review results will display the severity level, the validation code, the detailed validation message, and the applicable submitted value associated with the review result. You may also click Download CSV to download a copy of your validation results. To return to the Plan Validation Workspace, click Back. You must review all validation errors and make the required corrections to your QHP application templates before re-uploading them to the Plan Validation Workspace and attempting to validate them again until the Validation Results column displays a status of No Errors Found or Warnings Found. If any validation warnings are found, determine whether any updates are needed to your template data or whether you will need to submit any justifications or supporting documents within the QHP application section of the MPMS module after linking the template to a QHP application. Continue to upload all required templates within the Plan Validation Workspace, making corrections and re-uploading templates as needed based on validation results until all required templates for the upcoming submission deadline are validated. Next, let's walk through how to cross-validate a QHP application within the Plan Validation Workspace. Cross-validation is a required step for submitting an application, regardless of the applicable submission deadline. All issuers, regardless of state exchange model, are required to cross-validate their QHP application data prior to submitting it to CMS. Although issuers in states performing plan management functions and SBEFPs cross-validate their application data in their QHP application rather than the Plan Validation Workspace. For issuers in FFE states, navigate to the Plan Validation Workspace and click Cross-Validate at the bottom of the page. Please note that only templates with a status of No Errors Found and Warnings Found will be cross-validated. Upon cross-validation, the Cross-Validation Check section will be generated. This section displays the number and type of cross-validation checks performed based on the validated templates in the Plan Validation Workspace. Please note that these results only include cross-validations for templates in a validation status of No Errors Found or Warnings Found. If any errors or warnings are identified, select View Results to review the detailed cross-validation message. You may also click Download All Results (CSV) to download a copy of your cross-validation results. Please note that issuers and states performing plan management functions and SBEFPs with multiple binders who choose to cross-validate in the plan validation workspace may receive false positive cross-validation errors or warnings. While issuers are able to upload up to 4 versions of the plans and benefits template in the plan validation workspace, one for each market and/or product type, only one version of other templates can be uploaded at a time. Therefore, other templates may only correspond to a subset of an issuer's uploaded plans and benefits templates, generating false positive cross-validation errors. However, these errors will not block states from transferring data to MPMS. Once you have made the required corrections based on your cross-validation results, re-upload corrected templates to the plan validation workspace if necessary, and rerun the cross-validation checks until no errors are identified. If you have questions regarding how to navigate and use the HIOS MPMS module, please contact the Marketplace Service Desk at cms_feps@cms.hhs.gov or 855-CMS-1515. For more information about the QHP certification process, visit www.qhpcertification.cms.gov.